Welcome back to my New York Giants franchise. So obviously, once again, I am at my cousin's house. That's why the backdrop is completely different. In case you missed the last episode, I am dog-sitting at my cousin's house. Also, the room is much more open, so my voice is echoing way more than normal, so I apologize if it sounds worse through the microphone. But last episode was a frustrating one. We lost by 1 point to the Philadelphia Eagles, and it would have went into overtime if the kick meter didn't glitch when I was trying to make the extra point. It was a really annoying way to lose. It was very aggravating, but to be fair, we should not have been in that game at all. The Eagles gifted us so many opportunities, and it probably should have been a blowout, and I guess we just took advantage well of the Eagles' mistakes, but still, I don't think we should have been in that game in the slightest. But if you are new around here, if this is the first time you are visiting the channel, I would massively appreciate it if you could hit that subscribe button down below. If you're looking forward to some more Madden 21 franchise content, definitely consider hitting that subscribe button. But if you enjoy this video in particular, if you're enjoying the series, I would really appreciate your support by hitting that like button. It would help me out so much in the end. Also, a dog is walking by. So they have hardwood floors. You can definitely hear him just prancing around. So that's what that is in the background. But I think this episode, we're going to make some trades. So this is the trade deadline at midseason here. So I think this is a good spot to do something. I'm not going to make any kind of ridiculous trade for some kind of superstar player. I don't really want to go that route. But I do think I'm going to be a tad bit unrealistic and get another first round draft pick. I like having a lot of draft picks, and we did pretty well in that regard, at least for a bit. We got a second round draft pick from the Bears, I believe, for Golden Tate. I think I might have given away another draft pick to get that second, but I do want another first round draft pick, and I'm thinking about who to trade. So on the defensive line, Dalvin Tomlinson is on a contract year, and so is Leonard Williams. They are both on contract years. Leonard Williams is going to be much cheaper next year. It's just, I think he's franchise tagged right now. That's why he's so expensive at the moment. But I think I'm going to trade Dalvin Tomlinson. And the reason for that, Leonard Williams is now up to superstar development. So that's going to help him out a little bit. He might be able to progress a bit more. I kind of knew I wanted to keep one of these guys. I didn't want to keep both of them because we do still have, you know, BJ Hill, who's young. He's not bad at all. I'm pretty sure either next year or the year after that would be his contract season. So we'll have to figure out what to do with him, you know, in the future. But I do want BJ Hill to play a little bit more. And I do think that Dalvin Tomlinson will be the one leaving the team. I like Dalvin Tomlinson. I think he's definitely a good player. I didn't actually realize him and Leonard Williams are the same age. I thought Dalvin Tomlinson was a year or two younger. If that were the case, I'd probably be trading Leonard Williams, but since they're the same age, I'm gonna get rid of Dalvin Tomlinson. And also, Marcus Golden and Kyler Fackrell are both on contract years too, and I don't really want either of these players in the long term of this team. I don't know if I'll trade both of them. I probably won't. I think I'm gonna keep one just to have some pass rushing depth. Now, I think that both Golden and Fackrell will have about the same trade value. Golden might have a bit higher just because he's a higher overall, but he is less of a cap hit, so I do think I'm going to trade Kyler Fackrell. I think I'm going to trade with the Steelers. They seem to make the most sense out of all the teams that are interested in these players, just because, you know, they do really badly need a defensive tackle. Brandon Mebane, Zach Kerr, both aren't that great. They're 73 and 70. Chris Wormley's not too good. Dan McCullers, they could really badly use a defensive tackle. Now, right outside linebacker, they do have Bud Dupree, who isn't too bad. Left outside linebacker, of course, they have TJ Watt. But I do think they could probably rotate in Kyler Fackrell with Bud Dupree. I just think that out of all the teams interested, they do make the most sense. Maybe we can throw somebody else in this trade as well, just to give them a bit more value. You know, but of course, this is a really good trade for us. Not as much for the Steelers, but, you know, I'm going to break the realism just a little bit. I'm not trying to be hyper-realistic in this series, as you guys probably already know by now. But, you know, I just wanted to get another draft pick to make the draft more enjoyable, you know, for the viewers. And I can at least name another first-round draft pick after you guys. I think you guys will like that a lot in the end. So Dalvin Tomlinson, Kyler Fackrell, and Corey Coleman are heading to the Steelers. Now, they're not on a bad team, right? They definitely have some potential to win. That draft pick right now is projected to be 12th. Let me check out the Steelers a little bit. I want to see what their record's looking like here. So the Steelers are 3-4. The Browns look like they clearly have this division. So this could work out pretty well for us. If the Steelers continue to lose, that would be definitely ideal. I think that is the only trade I'm going to make. But we can sign some players now. We have 3 spots on the roster. So let's go ahead and get a defensive tackle at least, because we need, you know, another backup or right end or something. I think I might just go after James Lynch. Normal development, 64 overall. He doesn't seem too bad. So I'm going to go ahead and sign him. I might go after an outside linebacker, but I do think I'm going to bring Jakobi Meyers onto the team from the practice squad. I'm not sure how much he's going to play, but he might get involved a little bit. And then I'm going to go after an outside linebacker here. I'm going to go after Miles Humphrey here. Let's just bring him onto the team. He's a decent looking pass rusher at least. I think I'm also going to sign Quez Watkins. I'm probably going to put him on the practice squad, but he has a lot of speed. So maybe eventually he can make it onto the final roster. But for now, he is going to join the practice squad. And I think those are all of the signings I'm going to make in this episode. So we have another first round draft pick. I'm super excited for this one. But now we can actually get into the rest of the episode. We can talk to Sterling Shepard. He is frustrated. He's been kind of quiet on the field, apparently. I'm going to try to get him more involved. Sterling Shepard is a good player. He's played well for us this season, though. So we're going to see what happens. 5+ touches, 100 plus yards. I think we can at least get the touches. That shouldn't be too hard. Let's go ahead and scout some players now. A receiver is actually kind of a position I could be looking at the moment. I didn't realize how thin we were at the position, to be honest. And it's taking a really long time to load. There we go. So we already kind of looked at these receivers. Let me actually check out the draft stories first, because, you know, throughout this season, different players get tweeted about and whatnot, and you could potentially find some good gems that way. So let's go to the draft stories. We have one new draft story, Alan Watkins. He's a defensive back. All right, so let's see what he's all about. He could be a corner, could be a safety. He is this cornerback, and he looks incredibly good now with that B+ man coverage. That's new. So I really want Alan Watkins on the team. Of course, his name will be changed, but Alan Watkins looks really, really nice at the moment. So I think I'm going to go ahead and spend the rest of my scouting points on receiver. See if we can find some late round guys. We have Sean McLean. We have Keegan Bernard as well. Both of those players look pretty good. A- catching. Carl Smith does not look great at all. Okay, so we have two players down here who look like they could be pretty decent. Both really tall as well. 6'5", 233. Mid-second round talent. He looks like a great player to go after. Honestly, a much-needed, huge receiver option on this team, to be honest. Our receivers aren't the tallest, of course. Darius Slayton, Sterling Shepard, neither of them are really tall. So I think he could work really well as like the number one receiver or the number two or something. But the team right now, of course, is not that great. We're not playing too well this season. But, you know, I'm making the most out of this year. I'm honestly just looking for a good draft pick. If we can get a solid draft pick, I think this will be a successful season. Let's move BJ Hill to defensive tackle. I'm actually going to shift his position there permanently. Another team should be all ready for this next game. So we can get into the upgrade points now. This intro is probably going to be longer than normal just because of that trading sequence. But let's go with Jabril Peppers here. He's an 81 overall. I want him to continue fitting the scheme. He already has really good stats. He's good speed, good acceleration, good coverage ability as well. I'm just going to keep going into run support. Maybe make him a really, really hard-hitting safety. That would be huge. Nothing there to hit power, but 2 to tackling and awareness, 1 to man coverage and zone coverage. 82 overall now for him. Jacoby Myers potentially will get some targets this game. I'm not sure who our third receiver is. It might actually just be him. He's not too fast, which kind of sucks, but pretty good catching ability, good acceleration as well. Let's go into slot. He's not going to fit the scheme or anything like that, but slot's usually pretty glitchy. 2 to medium route running, 2 to short, and then 1 to catch in traffic. We're going to go into power for Riley Dixon. We'll probably get up awareness and kick accuracy. That's exactly what it got up. I don't understand this game sometimes, but Matt Pertnow, our starting right tackle. I don't know how long I want him starting, like at least for this season, but I don't think he's going to be the starter long term. I think he has potential in real life, but in this game, he's just not progressing all that quickly. I'm just going to keep going into agile. I want him to fit this scheme. Awareness, pass block finesse, and run block finesse all upgraded. Pass block finesse, though, by 2. Definitely not bad. And then Saquon Barkley. Of course, this team's, like, best player. So I just want him to be as good of a runner as possible. Obviously, he's amazing at everything. I don't really truck too much with him, so I don't want to really bother with that. Let's go into elusive back. He's going to be a 94 overall with his morale boost. 1-2, acceleration, agility, ball carrier, vision, and spin move. Okay, so Saquon Barkley, of course, is insane. And he's going to continue to be insane, most likely. Let's go ahead with the coach experience. Let's get the first upgrade package here. Increased player weekly goal XP, I think it is. Something like that. But yeah, I think the only thing we have to do now is talk about some players on the Buccaneers. So let's go ahead and do that. Of course, they have Tom Brady. He's going to be the first player I talk about. He is now their starting quarterback. So no more Jameis Winston. Tom Brady, a 90 overall, 43-year-old quarterback with superstar X-Factor. You guys all know about Tom Brady. He is insanely good, so he's going to be really hard to play against. He has really good accuracy ratings, of course, 96 short, 91 medium and deep. 90 throw power is still not too bad. Now, this team has the best wide receiver duo in the NFL, at least in my opinion, and I don't even really think it's all that close. Mike Evans and Chris Godwin are both incredibly talented. They also have some speed here. Paul Richardson's on the team. Scotty Miller is also very fast. But these two players are going to give us so much trouble today. We do not have the cornerbacks to be covering these guys. This team probably also has like the best tight end trio in the NFL then, because Gronk is very good, OJ Howard is very good, and then Cameron Brate is good as well. So we have to look out for all of these guys, to be honest. Now, this team's selection in the first round was Tristan Wirfs, an incredibly athletic offensive lineman. He has star development. Here's a quick look at the new uniforms as well. They're looking kind of clean in my opinion, but 77 speed, 83 acceleration. He is ridiculously athletic for being 320 pounds. He's a really good offensive tackle. I don't really think we're going to get through him all that easily, but I guess we'll see what happens with our edge rushers. And now this team's defense, I think, is very underrated. They have a really solid group of players on this side of the ball. Vita Vea, one of the league's best nose tackles. He's at least emerging as such. He's a really, really talented player. He's huge, 347 pounds, 87 overall. He is solid, and we're going to have to look out for him. Levante David is also a beast. 90 overall middle linebacker, superstar development. Devin White is on this team, one of the faster players at his position, 92 speed. Of course, they have Shaq Barrett, 87 overall, superstar development. He is very good as a pass rusher. This team's really good, in my opinion. I think the Buccaneers are going to compete well in real life, and I think they're going to give us a lot of trouble here in the game. But really quickly, before we hop into the game, I did change the sliders. I remembered to this time. So just briefly, I'm going to go over them. I moved run blocking down, actually. It's down to 38 now. I think it was at 50 before that. I think we're running the ball a bit too easily still. Interceptions and pass coverage, I'm pretty certain I bumped up. Their quarterback accuracy, I bumped down. Interceptions and pass coverage, I bumped down for them. And I forgot to do this, but run blocking, I'm going to move down to 40. I think these are all pretty fair right now. I don't want the games to be easy, but I also don't want them to be insanely difficult. And that's kind of how they've been so far. I don't think any game has been necessarily easy, but a lot of them have been near impossible. This has been a really long intro. I've been recording for like 20 minutes. I hope it's not that long, like in actuality. Kevin Zeitler can play again today, which is massive, but we're going to hop into this game here against the Buccaneers. All right, so we are out on offense first. I forgot to commentate over the kick. I usually do. My bad. But anyway, first down and 10, let's try to find Darius Slayton. I think he's going to be open. We're going to try to possession catch that, and that's getting picked off on the first play of the game. That is an excellent start here, boys. Sean Murphy bunting is gonna pick that one off. All right, well, it's like they received the kick then. Dude, come on. I thought I could get that one in there and possession catch it, but I could not. I need to come out running the ball way more, man. Well, Tom Brady is now on the field. That player is open in the flats. It is going to be Mike Evans, who's gonna break out of one tackle and almost pick up that first down. He gets 9 yards. Oh man, dude, I am so bad at passing the ball. It's insane, man. I thought that was open. I really did, but clearly it was not. That's going to be a great pass breakup, though. Chris Godwin, the intended receiver. Honestly, I could move Logan Ryan over, but it really doesn't even matter. Chris Godwin and Mike Evans are both ridiculous, so I don't really think it matters who he covers. Anyway, though, that's going to be a very easy first down. Okay, that was blocked incredibly well. Ronald Jones, the speedy running back there, taking that one for a gain of about 11 yards. Of course, no Leonard Fournette on their team in this franchise. He is still with the Jaguars, but first and 10 is Xavier McKinney. Let's try to do something with him. It's going to be a run play to Ronald Jones, getting wrapped up quite nicely by Ryan Connolly. There's Coach Trambush talking to Daniel Jones about his decision to throw that pass. It wasn't the best decision, I can tell you that much. Another run play here to Ronald Jones. He's going to meet a couple defenders, but power his way into the end zone. Good drive by them, but they only had to go like 20 yards. Yeah, okay. So it's third down and 23 now. Those first two plays, absolutely forgettable. I'm just going to throw it up to Evan Engram. He's been our savior so many different times, and he can almost make that catch there. That would have been massive. This has been the worst start we've had on offense in a while. But hopefully we can bounce back at some point. I feel like I'm going to need to rely on the defense to make a big play here. I missed that tackle completely. But I feel like I'm going to have to rely on the defense. And they have not been reliable this year at all. So it seems like we're in line for a tough one. Oh, man. But the Buccaneers definitely have the better team. So I feel like we should lose this one. But you never know, man. That's going to be open in the flats. Only like a gain of two there. All right, third down in inches. This would be a really big stop from us if we can make this. I'm going to call some man coverage. It probably won't work with these receivers, but they're going to run the ball. It's LeSean McCoy. If I didn't know by the number or anything like that, you could tell by the way he carries the football. The way he carries the football always gives me like so much anxiety, even if I'm not a fan of the team he's on. I just think it's going to get like stripped out every single time. Oh, I almost read that beautifully. That's going to be Gronk on the reception. Man, that would have been a huge play, but Tom Brady's been checking down a ton so far. That's kind of the narrative with Tom Brady, right? It's not absolutely true, but you know what I mean. Second down and four. Excellent cutback there from Ronald Jones. He picks up 5 yards and that first down. Dude, we're really bad in run defense. I thought this team was going to be good at run defense just because of the, you know, the defensive line of the front seven. Actually, the linebackers aren't great, but the defensive line is really good on this team. Ryan Connolly making a good play there. Second down and 9 after that one. Let's be on Darnay Holmes here. Let's see what he can do. That's nearly an interception by Leonard Williams, actually. That was batted down by Blake Martinez, who makes a really good play on the ball. And Leonard Williams actually almost came up with that one. That would have been so big. We're going to guess pass. Actually, could not get that off in time. That's fine. Ryan Connolly, make a play. No, the safety's going to make a play. Jabril Peppers is getting an interception. Return this. You have a lot of space. Jabril Peppers is going to get this one at least out to the 20. That's what you look for if you're returning one out of the end zone. There we go, to the 25-yard line. What a play. Our first pick in such a long time against Tom Brady, of all people. Okay, Saquon, take this handoff up the middle, my dude. Saquon Barkley has a ton of space. He can't really juke out that player. That's fun. But anyway, that's a first down. Finally, we do something on offense. Also, he now has 1,000 yards on the season, which is massive. I'm going to queue up some play action. Let's see if we can get Sterling Shepard open all the way across the field. I think in a second he's going to be open. Sterling Shepard is wide open. He's going to make that catch as well. Let's go. That's a really big gain. 22 yards. Daniel Jones finally completes a pass as well. Let's see if we can continue rolling here on this drive. There we go. Good blocking to the outside. Saquon Barkley is nearly picking up that first down. He picks up about 5. It'll bring up 3rd down and 1. I don't really want to pass this, but I think I'm going to come out in a pass and then probably audible to a run. Let's go with that. Deion Lewis checks in, but I feel like he can at least pick up this first down. Deion Lewis straight up the middle is going to pick up that first down, and he doesn't fumble. I waited to commentate there because it looked like Devin White was trying to rip the ball free. Now, I don't know if you guys know this, but Shaquille Barrett's a good player. He sacked me on that one. 3rd and 14 now after that. That's a huge overthrow, I think, but Javon Wims! No way you came down with that one. What? The new starting receiver, what a grab. I need to take another look at this one. He's a big man, so I decided to throw this one up. He's also pretty open right here. Decently sized window to throw this one into. Danny Dimes sails it a little bit, but Wims makes the beautiful adjustment and is going to come down with that one. That's a great catch. Let's keep this drive going. I don't want that to go to waste. I'm going to run the ball, I think. I don't really want to try to pass the ball here. Saquon Barkley is going to pick up a touchdown. He actually fumbled, but I don't think it's going to count. Yeah, it's going to be a touchdown. Okay, awesome. So there we go. We're going to tie up the game. Saquon Barkley has been our MVP this season 100%, but that's fully what I expected going into this year. I feel like it's been such a long time since this team has gotten an interception. There we go. That's going to be a completion really quickly to Chris Godwin. There's a first down. That's a gain of 12, like, immediately. All right, well, I guess we need to play better man coverage. He got open way too quickly. I'm going to go man coverage again, I think. McKinney is supposed to be covering Gronk. See how he does. That could be pass interference on me, to be honest. I kind of ran into Gronk quite a bit there. That is going to be pass interference on me. And it didn't even show the ref for some reason. I don't know what that was all about. That one was on me. I ran completely into Gronk, like, that entire time. Gronk is wide open in the flats. That's such an easy first down for him as well. And Tom Brady's starting out 6 for 9. That's what you like to see. I changed the camera angle by accident. Did not mean to do that. And that's not going to be a tackle. I am spamming X. Just, like, go out and tackle him. What happened? How did you not bring him down? I could have sworn Ryan Connolly was close enough. So after one, it is 7-7. Ronald Jones getting that handoff for the first play of the second quarter. He has a touchdown in this one. So both running backs, both starting running backs, have a touchdown in this game so far. Both teams also have a pick. Second down and 7. Tom Brady under center. That's so open. I left that completely. Yeah, that's on me, but I really thought Tom Brady was going to check down. I feel like if I peeled back and covered Chris Godwin, he had the tight end wide open, which obviously I would have much rather had him throw to because that would not have probably went to the 1 yard line. That one was on me. But anyway, there's a good stop on the first play of this set of downs. Ronald Jones going nowhere. Do something. Sack Tom Brady. We're going to get back there. It's Dexter Lawrence bringing down Tom Brady. Now third and goal at the 11-yard line. Let's send some more pressure, man. I wish Shane Zimenez in coverage. I don't like this too much, but I'm going to try to user him, see if we can make it work. That is open across the middle, and Chris Godwin has the touchdown. That blitz did not get back there soon enough, and there were so many players around there to cover. I'm going to look for Darius Slayton on the streak here, and then if not, Saquon Barkley. Saquon should be open. He's going to be wide open. There we go. That's a beautiful pass. While he was getting sacked, Daniel Jones delivers a dime. That was a tremendous throw. Saquon picks up 27 yards. There we go. Let's give the ball to Barkley again. Levante David will get blocked. Saquon Barkley is going to spin out a defender and almost pick up that first. I don't think they're going to give it to him. It's going to be second down in inches now, but still, that was a really good play. I can probably keep this one on the ground again. I'm going to run this one straight up the middle here, inside zone. Saquon Barkley, just pick up the first. He's going to get the first down, and he's going to power through a defender as well. Saquon Barkley running really well at the moment. Darius Slayton being pressed. I like this a lot. He doesn't get too open, but Saquon's wide open. In the end zone, Saquon Barkley is going to make the grab. I'm so happy I was able to find him. If I got sacked on that play, I would have never forgiven myself because Saquon was so open. Let's go. We're going to tie this one up 14-14, about halfway, a little less than halfway through the second quarter. That's going to be picked off. Darnay Holmes, let's go. What kind of throw was that by Tom Brady? I have no idea, but Darnay Holmes in the area. That was such a huge play, and now we could potentially find Sterling Shepard. I like this play a lot. Hopefully, he gets open. Let's see if we have the time to throw this one. We should have the time. Sterling Shepard's wide open. Make these defenders miss. No, you're not going to be able to. That's fine. Down to the 8-yard line. That's a really good start to the drive. Let's keep it going, boys. Come on. We could do this. We can take the lead. I have faith here. I'm going to try to scramble this one myself. Danny Dimes just has a touchdown. Nobody came up to tackle him. Okay. Daniel Jones. All right, man. I like the celebration. Honestly, man, you blink a little bit, and sometimes you can't tell if it's Lamar Jackson or Daniel Jones back there, man. He's looking great on the ground. 21-14. I actually can't believe we are taking the lead. I didn't expect to ever get the lead in this game, but the team's playing well. Let's go, boys. Aside from that one pick, I think this game has gone pretty well for us. We really haven't made too many big mistakes. We're getting some turnovers, which is huge. Well, that play's not going to be a turnover. You are wide open. That's probably Paul Richardson. He looks injured, maybe? No, he's getting up. Okay, that is Paul Richardson. Chris Godwin is very open. He's going to break out of a tackle attempt as well. Chris Godwin is so hard to cover, man. He is such a great player. Mike Evans hasn't really been a factor yet today. I think he has like one or two catches. He hasn't done too much. Another sack, though, on Tom Brady. This time, Lorenzo Carter getting back there. Nice job with the pass rush today, man. We're doing pretty well on defense, to be completely honest. We have two turnovers, have a couple sacks. Let's go, man. We're not making this game easy for Tom Brady. It's going to be a screen pass. LeSean McCoy is going to catch that one. Pick up a good bit there, actually. It'll be third down and 11. I'm going to send a blitz. Let's see if we can get back there quickly. We're not going to really get back there quickly, but I don't think Tom Brady is going to make this for the first down. He won't. The pass will be completed to Gronk, but he is short by 8 yards. They should come out and take the field goal. The kick is actually not good. There are like 13 miles per hour winds in this one, and that's going to affect Matt Gay on the attempt. Okay. Dude, this could be a huge opportunity for us. Let's see if we can continue our lead. I don't really want to go with an RPO. I don't really like RPOs too much. So let's just run the ball here with Saquon up the middle. They're kind of stacking the box a little bit, but I still feel comfortable running this. Saquon Barkley is going to pick up like 4 yards or so there. Not a bad run. Okay, man, we're playing pretty well on offense. I don't want to jinx anything. Knock on wood. But we're playing pretty well on offense. Let's run the ball here to the outside. That player did not get blocked. Elijah Penny, please. Is it that difficult for you to just throw your body out there? You're a big man, dude. Come on. Just block someone. All right, well, let's go with the pass. Go with the screen pass here to Saquon. It worked pretty well last week a couple times. It's going to work well here, too. Saquon Barkley is going to juke out someone, apparently. Are you still not down? Okay. That took a while, but Saquon's going to pick up a good bit there. Third down and one. I'm going to come out in a pass, but probably audible. Actually, I don't know if I want to audible. I'm just going to drag Evan Engram and probably find him. He's not super open, actually. Triangle, maybe? Saquon's going to make that catch. Is that a first down? I hope it is. That is a first down. Okay, good play. Okay, so once again, Darius Slayton is being pressed. I'm going to streak him almost every time he gets pressed. Darius Slayton, go up. Darius Slayton is going to make the catch for the touchdown. Let's go. Darius Slayton is so good, man. That's his fifth receiving touchdown on the year. It is 28-14, or it's about to be. The kick is up, and it should be good. So 28-14, and not at all what I expected. Bruce Arians is struggling over there. Tom Brady isn't having the best of games. Of course, the game's not even close to being over. We have an entire second half of football to play and this drive here from the Buccaneers. But let's continue playing good defense. Mike Evans is going to catch that one, man, for nearly another first. It's going to be like second down and one, okay. They're not going to pass the ball. They're not going to run the ball, I mean. They are passing the ball. Tom Brady in trouble. He's going down again. O'Shane Zimenez this time getting back there. This should take us to the second half here. So that's a really good first half here, honestly, on both sides of the ball. This Buccaneers offense is terrifying. They have so many different options, and we've done a really good job at bottling them up. 14 points in the first half to this offense is not bad. We have a couple interceptions. We have like three sacks. The team is playing well. And then offensively, we scored 28 points. We're doing really well on that side of the ball. One really stupid interception should not have thrown that pass, but Daniel Jones has been really good since then. And that pass was not his fault at all. Daniel Jones is having a really good game for us. Saquon's also playing well. Let's go, man. Let's keep it up. That's completely on me, though. I abandoned that gap entirely. LeSean McCoy is going to pick up that first down. I thought I could maybe shoot the other gap and get behind him, but LeSean McCoy is still a bit too fast. All right, now it's third down and three. This is a big play. I don't really like playing man coverage on third down and short because I feel like someone will just get open right away and Tom Brady is going to see him. So we're going to go with some zone. Gronk is wide open. I could not catch up to him, so I decided just to let him go and hope that Tom Brady threw it underneath instead. Man, I didn't play that too well. With Ryan Connolly. That's on me. Gronk ran a beautiful route there, though. And now Tom Brady's in the zone. Not at all what we want to see. It's going to be a run play. Ronald Jones, for some reason, decided to cut back. I don't know why. He had the lane just in front of him. And for some reason, just gave it all up. That was strange. I went for the interception. I don't know why. Chris Godwin's going to catch that one. Tom Brady only has four incompletions, and two of those have been interceptions. So the passing is still ridiculous, but at least they're throwing picks now. I feel like this is going to be a pass, but I'm also going to pinch the middle. It's a really quick pass to the outside that's getting picked off by Logan Ryan. No way! A former teammate of Tom Brady is going to pick it off. I can't believe we have forced Tom Brady to throw three interceptions, and none have been because of me. They've literally all been because of the computer, but I love it. Man, if I get better at this game and the computer continues to play like this, we are going to be a lethal team. Okay, well now it's third down and nine. This drive hasn't been great so far. I'm going to try to find Sterling Shepard underneath. It depends where Levante David goes, really. Sterling Shepard's going to be really open. There he is. Sterling Shepard is going to try to accelerate around the edge of those players. He can't do it, but that's fine. That's a really nice gain. Sterling Shepard's been great today, man. 4 for 66. He needs one more catch to not be frustrated anymore, I guess. I don't know, but we're going to run the ball here. They only have three down linemen, so I think this can work pretty well. As long as we block the linebackers, they are blocked fairly well. Saquon Barkley is going to accelerate for a gain of around eight, and this offense has been great so far. Okay, so now it's third down and four. Let's see if we can potentially find Sterling Shepard across the middle. He's going to be open right away. He's going to make that catch as well. I probably could have rat caught that one, but I was kind of worried about him dropping it. So I figured why not just possession catch it and make sure we get the completion. Dude, this team has been really good so far, man. Let's keep it up, man. I don't want to take my foot off the gas pedal because anything can happen here on All Madden. Saquon Barkley up the middle has been doing a really good job all day on those runs, averaging about 5 yards per carry. Saquon's been good through the air as well. Saquon Barkley picking up another first down. He has been a great pass catcher for us this season. Okay, here we go, man. Okay, I attempted two straight passing plays, and they did not work. So now it is third down and 10. Let's see if we can find Javon Wims. Again, I don't like him that much, but Evan Engram is going to be open. I almost said Sterling Shepard. Evan Engram is going to pick up 10, and that's another first down. This drive has been perfect. Here we go, boys. Let's try to throw this one to Darius Slayton here. He's going to be open. That's another touchdown. Let's go, boys. We're going to put up 35 right now on the Buccaneers. Oh, Mike Evans wide open there. Ryan Connolly kind of in coverage. That was never going to work. Right, Tom Brady calling some kind of audible here, completely changing the formation. Most likely a pass play. It's going to be a pass play. Chris Godwin is really open to the outside. Make the hit, somebody. No, we can't do it. That's a completion. Chris Godwin going up against Logan Ryan there. That's a really good run blocking, man, to the outside. Ronald Jones has an easy gain of like 14 yards there. 13 yards or so. Oh, you are very open. Chris Godwin running a perfect route against Darnay Holmes. His second receiving touchdown today. Saquon Barkley is going to swerve around a little bit. Almost pick up that first down. That's fine, though. I'm sure we can pick this one up third down and one. Let's go with another run play to Saquon, just up the middle. Vita Vea is there, and that worries me because he's really good. But let's see if we can just run this one right past him. He did get double teamed. He's going to make the play, though, but is that enough for the first? It's going to be fourth down in inches. I'm going to go for this just because the fullback dive is such a successful play. I don't think they're going to stop this. Elijah Penny, put your shoulder down, pick up this first down. Elijah Penny is going to get destroyed. Oh my gosh. Are you okay? I'm sorry. I'm sorry that I threw you into that run play. You got obliterated by Ndamukong Suh, but it's okay. Jesus, man. He hit the ground so hard. I don't even think he realized what happened. Someone needs to test him out for a concussion or something. But first down and 10, let's run the ball again. Saquon, get to this outside. Devin White is very fast. He almost can catch up to you, but not quite. Saquon still has the speed over him. See if I can maybe find Sterling Shepard. He looks really open to me. Let's go, Sterling Shepard. Maybe not really open, but still comfortable throwing that pass. I think that's at least 5 catches for him as well. That was his 6th catch, so there we go. I'm going to look for Darius Slayton on the slant. Give it a second. He's going to be open. There he is. Darius Slayton is going to pick up a gain of about 15. That was way more than 15, actually. That was like 19. So the dogs I'm watching just started to freak out like right as I called this play. So I think I'm in the middle of a play. I am in the middle of a play. What is happening? Okay. R1 is going to make the catch. Sterling Shepard, let's go for the first down. I completely forgot what play I called, but it worked out. Oh, Saquon Barkley, let's go! Accelerate! No! You can't get the touchdown, but you're down at the 2. So I really do not like the formation we're in right now, but I'm kind of forced to run the ball. I don't think the pass would work at all, so let's just take our loss. Or take our touchdown, never mind! Okay, dude, this offense is so good at the moment. What is happening? Deion Lewis with the touchdown, that normally gets destroyed. Especially when they run a goal line defense. Normally runs up the middle do not work. But let's go. 42-21. The Buccaneers on upset alert with 8 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Man, this could be a huge game for us. Let's go. But let's just play some good defense here. I want to be conservative with the ball on offense as well. I don't want to throw anything stupid. I don't want to throw any picks and give them a chance to come back into this one. Tom Brady's in the zone. Let's play well in defense here. It's going to be a pass to the flats. LeSean McCoy isn't really picking all that much up. You can have that all day, man. You can have that the rest of the game. I don't mind. I just don't want you guys scoring in a couple plays. We're getting pressure on Tom Brady. He's going to keep backtracking. And Leonard Williams coming up with the sack. Alex Kappa's going down. I believe one of their starting guards. But Leonard Williams, I'm glad I didn't trade you. Ryan Connolly now. Let's see what you can do. Third down and 21. Just play the sticks. That's all I'm caring about here. He's throwing it deep. It's Chris Godwin versus Jabril Peppers, and that's pass interference. No way. Come on. I was holding square just to swat the ball away, and that's going to be a huge penalty. Man, we bailed him out on that one. That wasn't even a good ball. There's LeSean McCoy in the flats, and for some reason, James Bradbury is like peeling off. He's done that several times this year, and I don't get why. It's strange. He just does not want to tackle anything. I'm going to pinch the D-line. If this is slants, this is going to be a touchdown. But if it's a run play, maybe we can make the stop. Looks like it's going to be slants, and that's not a touchdown. That was a terrible throw by Tom Brady. Fourth down and goal. They have to go for this. They're lining up to go for it. I'm going to run commit. It's going to be a run play. We're going to get back there and make the goal line stand. Daniel Jones coming back out. Definitely his best performance of this season. But honestly, I want to keep the ball in Saquon Barkley's hands. I don't want to mess this game up. 4.5 minutes left. Let's just run the ball as much as we can on this drive. Saquon Barkley shooting straight up the middle, picking up 4 yards. Not a bad start. Okay, I've been strictly running the ball on this drive, and if we get one more first down, the game is over. Saquon Barkley's gonna do just that. Let's go, Saquon. He's gonna keep going. Let's see if we can get this man a touchdown. We can't. Saquon Barkley down to the 29-yard line. Let's go, man. We're gonna win this one. And for the first time all season, we can call a quarterback kneel. Oh, it feels great. Daniel Jones is going to take a knee, and this game is going to be over. We actually crushed the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. 42-21. It feels good to be on the giving end of one of these massacres. Essentially, everything on this team was good today. Like, the offense balled out. We had so many touchdowns. Daniel Jones played really well in specific. He had that one pick on the first play of the game, but after that, he was tremendous. Saquon was really good. He had 180 yards on the ground, and I want to say like 80 yards through the air with a couple of touchdowns. At least through the air, I think he had a touchdown. I'm pretty sure on the ground he had one too. And then the defense was also insane. Tom Brady still had a crazy completion percentage, but that doesn't really matter because he threw 3 interceptions. But Daniel Jones, definitely his best game today. 20 of 27, 74% completion percentage, 3 touchdowns and an interception. Yeah, he had a really good day. That interception was entirely my fault, so take that away, and he was essentially perfect. Honestly, he did not make like a single mistake. He had a couple missed throws, but mainly that was because he was being pressured or he was like throwing out of a sack or something. Saquon was ridiculous today, 6.6 yards per carry. We had 3 touchdowns on the ground. Really, really effective numbers there. Receiving wise, Saquon 7 for 79 and a touchdown. Darius Slayton 3 for 48 and 2 touchdowns. Sterling Shepard almost gets 100 yards. Let's go, man. This team played so well. Matthew Peart letting up 1 sack isn't great, but still, if he's the only one letting up a sack, I'll take it. On the defensive side, 10 tackles for Ryan Connolly, a bunch of tackles for loss today, a bunch of sacks today as well, and 3 interceptions. We played so well on both sides of the ball. Okay, well, for some reason, it took me to the main menu. Please tell me that game saved, because that was such a good one. I don't want to have to super sim that one. It did save. That's really good to see. But let's talk to Sterling Shepard. He's no longer frustrated, it would seem, right? Because we gave him 7 targets. Not 7 targets, 7 catches, probably more than that. But there we go. He has 2,000 experience now, plus 20 morale for him as well. Let's get it, man. This was a really good week. I really like how the team played. The Buccaneers now have the same record as we do, which is very interesting. But let's advance to next week where we have to take on the football team again. So Washington destroyed us the last time we played. Dwayne Haskins looked like Patrick Mahomes. So this is going to be a tough matchup once again. They may be 2-5, but they certainly do not play like it. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed this one, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye. This is